Now, speaking of disaster management, social media giants Facebook and Twitter have now both banned Holocaust denial and revisionism as an extension to their terms of accepted speech. And this comes much to the applause of many. But while Holocaust denial is wrong, the question arises, are you sure that you want social media companies to be the ones to police speech? Well, joining me now to discuss is legal counsel for the Israeli digital rights movement, attorney Jonathan Klinger. Jonathan, thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you for inviting me.
It's our pleasure. All right, now, first off, is there an issue of violating First Amendment rights here?
Israel doesn't have a First Amendment, but if we observe free speech at all here, then the question is not just whether free speech is preserved, but more of whether content should be moderated at all. Is Facebook a mere conduit? Is it just a stupid pipe meant to convey data from one person to another, or is it a publisher? The actual involvement of Facebook in contents may incur liability later on, because if its policy is to remove some content and not to remove other content, then based on that policy, it actually takes liability on itself, at least under Israeli law, when it doesn't remove content. Let's say I report content A or B to be anti-Semitic and Facebook declines to remove it, having reviewed it. Do we want Facebook liable in such a case, or don't we want it liable? Now, the fact that Facebook moderates and becomes actually the court, where Facebook has separate interests, which include advertisement, which include relationship with other entities, and which include political parties. We see it also when they remove and censor posts by Trump or refuse to remove them.
Well, so again, though, you know, how do you draw the line? Because there have been many accusations against Twitter, Facebook, and others for limiting speech that they deem as hateful, but they might not be, like political assertions or ideologies. So again, how do you draw that line, if at all?
If you want to draw a line, the line should be drawn by legislators, not by Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, TikTok, or whoever has their own political and financial interests. When you give them the line to be both the judge, the jury, and the executioner, you cause these speeches or actual posts by people to be subject to the will of Facebook. I've dealt with a case where a person that was critical on Facebook was blocked from Facebook because of his criticism. There's another pending case that I litigate now of a person removed by Facebook. He claims that his posts were sarcastic. When we cross-examined the witness from Facebook, we heard that they just don't have the kind of means to understand sarcasm by content moderation. Mm-hmm. And giving them the absolute discretion and not giving it back to the community is a problem. When Facebook decides to censor Holocaust denial, it sounds great. It sounds like they're on the good side of history. But the problem is that once they do that, they choose what to remove or not to remove. What about other genocides, not just the Holocaust? What about scam? What about invasion of privacy? Who gets to choose what to censor and what not? And whether this should be done by Facebook or by our elected representatives? I believe that the elected representatives should govern here.
All right. Jonathan Klinger, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.